This exhibition, Lucy and Catherine Maddox Brown, focuses on the lives of two extraordinary Victorian women artists who were the daughters of Ford Maddox Brown. Ford Maddox Brown is known as the unofficial Pre-Raphaelite in that he was never part of the Pre-Raphaelite movement, but was both influenced and an influencer of the Pre-Raphaelites. And his daughters have always been displayed as part of that history. They were talented artists in their own right, but this is the first time that they've had the spotlight to themselves. One of the extraordinary things that we're showing in this exhibition is a Pre-Raphaelite childhood. And what we mean by that is that Lucy and Catherine grew up surrounded by Pre-Raphaelite thinkers. They are actually half-sisters, so one of the important things to note is that they didn't grow up together. But they had Pre-Raphaelite childhood in two ways, in terms of the people they met, but also in terms of the ideas they encountered. So Lucy she lodged with the Rossetti family and was tutored by Francis and Maria Rossetti, coming into contact with Pre-Raphaelite ideals in that way, while Catherine grew up with Ford Maddox Brown and was apprenticed in his studio at the age of 13. And both sisters grew up immersed in his studio practice as they were models for his work from a very early age. We have an exhibition, Pretty Barlands, where Catherine features as a babe in arms. But they were also surrounded by people like Dante Gobbo and Rossetti, who Catherine knew as Uncle Gubby, and they knew people like Holman Hunt, William Holman Hunt. Again, in her memoir, she remembered how he was a gentle figure with a smile, a dimpled smile, and he was very kind to her. Another artist, Lois Cato Dickinson, gave great children's parties, and they would play at William Morris's house, where William Morris would enact the fairy tales like Beauty and the Beast, and would perform the role of the Beast, and they would play with Mae Morris. So they were surrounded by these familiar figures of the Pre-Raphaelite circle, and were schooled in these ideas. They were both endowed with rare sympathies for the beautiful as a result of their upbringing.